Hi, this is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Stock Technologies, Solapur. In the last lecture, we have discussed regarding performance of automobile part 1. Now, in this particular chapter, we will see the performance curves. And after end of this session, the student will be able to understand and apply the performance curves of an automobile. Automobile performance is based on acceleration, ability to go up a slope, top speed, fuel economy, noise level, durability. Automobile gearboxes are basically designed for maximum acceleration, and these particular gearboxes are used for variable speeds. Accordingly, the engine power is utilized. And here, 80% of power of an engine is used to develop a extra 20% of torque. Therefore, we need to discuss a performance curve, how the automobile perform in different gears. Now we'll see, this is the performance curve, which is power available versus the road speed. Now you can see over here, when your vehicle is starts from its initial position, that time what will happen? It require more torque. Torque means what? You require more power. So initially, in the first gear, if your vehicle is in full throttle, then you are applying more power and you are having low speed, and this time you are getting more torque. So when your vehicle is getting accelerated, that time again for second gear, when you apply, that time you have to utilize full acceleration for second gear to move your vehicle, likewise for third gear, likewise for fourth gear. Now here you can see where you will get the maximum velocity by utilizing the maximum power, that is at the fourth gear. In the fourth gear, the driving wheels is getting the speed as same as that of the engine speed. Now this is the particular point where F is equal to R. F is nothing but the tractive effort and R is nothing but the total resistance. So here there is no surplus power. Here entire power of a vehicle is utilized to maximize the speed of the vehicle. Now here you can see the normal throttle condition. So here if you are using a vehicle at normal throttle condition, then this is the particular point where you will get the economic speed, where you will get fuel economy. So in our vehicle, on the speedometer, it is shown the fuel economy gauge. So whatever the range is given, fuel economy range, within that if you are traveling the vehicle, definitely you will get the more fuel economy. So this is regarding the performance curve of a vehicle, and this same performance curve is plotted for every vehicle. The nature of the performance curve is same for all the vehicle. If nature of performance curve differs, then definitely we can say the performance of automobile is not a good. Now we are having the some of the performance parameters. According to that, we are looking towards the performance of a vehicle. One is acceleration, second one is gradability, and third one is drawbar pull. Now here you can see the graph is plotted against tractive effort and road speed. Initially, tractive effort means what? It is the it is the force required to the vehicle between road and the driving wheel. So now that force, if you are utilizing initially for the first gear more, then your vehicle is getting more torque and your vehicle is moving from its original position. And for the second gear, you require less tractive effort because your vehicle is in movement. And for third gear, again you require less tractive effort. Again for the fourth gear, you require very less tractive effort, and you will get maximum speed at this particular point when your vehicle is in full throttle condition and at the top gear. So here F is equal to R again, there is no surplus power available. Now when the vehicle is accelerated, all the rotating parts of the vehicles are accelerated, due to which the weight of the vehicle is going to increase. Therefore weight of the vehicle from W to WE, that is increased, and that particular increasing weight is called as effective weight of a vehicle. Now hence we will see what is surplus power. Surplus power is nothing but F by V divided by 3600 into eta T. Here F is nothing but tractive effort, and sometimes we are taking, if the required power is there, we are taking over here instead of F the required that is the resistance. Now F is equal to MA. Here we are denoting acceleration as F, and M is equal to WE, we are taking effective weight of an vehicle. Therefore F is equal to what? 1 upon WE. Surplus power is nothing but power of an engine and power required, power available at engine and power required for an engine. So here we'll see the eta T, if we take inside, then we'll get tractive effort from power available and road resistance from power required. So this is the formula to calculate the acceleration for the vehicle. Now gradability. What is the gradability? The maximum percentage grade which a vehicle can negotiate with full rated condition is known as gradability. Hence, again the same formula, surplus power is equal to force into velocity upon 3600 into eta T. Now that is converted, and here instead of acceleration we have taken gradability. But this gradability is in percentage, therefore we have in the denominator we have multiplied by 100. So from this we will get the gradability with the help of this particular formula. Now what is meant by drawbar pull? When the excess power is fully utilized for pulling the extra load attached to the vehicle, then maximum drawbar pull is equal to tractive effort minus road resistance, that is equal to F minus R. This F minus R is nothing but when your vehicle is not at full throttle condition, that time you are having a surplus power, and that surplus power is nothing but your drawbar pull, and that drawbar pull we are utilizing for climbing the grade, we are utilizing for accelerating the vehicle, and we are utilizing this particular drawbar pull for carrying out the extra load. So these are the three advantages from which we can say the performance can vary with the help of drawbar pull. So road resistance in this section is made up of rolling resistance and air resistance only. Here we are not considering the grade resistance. If we need to consider the grade, then definitely what will happen, that particular surplus power we are taking into account for climbing the grade. So therefore this particular drawbar pull, if it is available in the vehicle, then we are utilizing this particular drawbar pull for carrying out the extra load, for maximizing the acceleration, and for speeding the vehicle. References are this. Thank you.